Vessels are scheduled for dry docking once every 5 years. After extended periods of sailing and service, it is common for marine growth to build up on the sides of the vessel. And hull painting of the vessel is one of the main reasons for dry docking, as it ensures efficient vessel operations and less fuel consumption for the next dry docking. So how do the shipyard personnel paint vessel's hull? Ask any painter and you'll learn that 90% of the work is preparation. Applying the paint itself is the easy part. The preparation consists of fresh water washing and spot dry blasting to bare metal. Shipyard personnel use fresh water high pressure machines to remove marine growth and chlorides from the ship's side. After completion the preparation stage, three coating of primer and final coating should be applied. Humidity should be always less than 65% before painting of each coating of the layer. The underwater side is painted with anti-fouling paint to prevent marine growth and ensures the vessel operates close to its original design speed and fuel consumption.
I will show you the valve vacuum pressure test during dry dock.
Pressure vacuum valves are designed to provide protection of all cargo tanks against over or under pressure and provide for the flow of small volumes of tank atmosphere resulting from temperature variations in the cargo tanks and should operate in advance of the pressure vacuum breaker where a G system is in use. So, as the name suggests, the PV valve consists of two valves. Pressure valve that activates under a set of positive pressure and a vacuum valve that activates under a set of negative pressure.
Now PV valve is ready for the test.
You see the hydrostatic measuring level which consists of two tubes interconnected with pressure vacuum pump and PV valve. The left tube shows positive pressure and the right tube shows negative pressure. In our case, pressure test should be done at 1400 mm water grade and vacuum test at minus 350 mm water grade according to manufacturer's instructions.
Minus 400, It is 1400.
Yes.
And the cap is freely moving. Now vacuum test. For the vacuum test, it should be 350 millimeters water grade.
The hydrostatic gauges of the lever should be stable.
This is the vacuum gauge, 1300. This is pressure liquid, 950. So now it's almost 350 vacuum.
When vacuum valve and bypassing the under pressure. I want to show you the live boat David test, static and dynamic, with the use of shore crane. Solas requires to carry out dynamic test with higher loads every 5 years. This load is 10% higher than the weight of the boat with all its complements and equipments. You see suspension block with link. Limit switch. This is boat winch. This is handbrake lever. The main element of the Liveboat David braking system is a David winch. If the brakes are not in good condition, Liveboat operations are liable to cause accidents. There are two brakes in the gravity type lifeboats: the static brake, which holds the lifeboat, and the centrifugal brake, which controls the lowering speed. There are two ways in which this test could be conducted. First is by placing the required weight inside the boat and then lowering the boat with the davit. The second way is suspending the physical weight on lifeboat davit. As this test is usually carried out in dry dock with easy availability of shore crane and weights, the second option usually preferable. The weight is read by the crane driver, who has a strain gauge in the control cap of the crane. He radios the information down to the people on deck. Then the crane slacks its hoisting wire so the davits take the strain. And this is called the static test. The David arms themselves are tested at the factory at 2.2 times the weight that they will ever have to carry, so it is much stronger. For the dynamic test, the manual brake on the winch is lifted and the box is lowered the same way you would lower the lifeboat. Then the lowering speed is measured. It should be between 0.75 and 1.30 meters per minute. If the lowering speed is too slowly or too fast, the centrifugal speed control brake needs adjusting. Then, after about 6 seconds, the manual brake is thrown back full force and the lowering stops. This is rather spectacular, with the blocks bouncing up and down.